So first we are going to taste white ales.
Yeah.
White ales is the most fresh, fruity and easy to drink wine of La Viñeta.
Mm-hmm.
And here we work with 5 different local type of grapes. In this case you can find Macabeu and white Grenache, more than 50 years old, so all vineyards.
Wow. Yeah.
And a little bit of Charello, Muscat and Malvasia.
And how big is the area?
Yeah, well, La Viñeta is a young project, so we started in 2002. Mm-hmm. And we started by a chance when we met Jordi Tolman from Mollet. Jordi had a very old vineyard, and in that time he was tired, a little bit depressed. He hasn't got children, so in that time sold the vineyards, we both, with my husband, but we just both with one condition, that Jordi still working with us.
Ah, yeah, because good idea, yeah.
Because in that time we were studying,
yeah,
and our family don't come from the wine business, they are butchers, okay? So we started just with 3 hectares, the other side of the road, and step by step, every year we took care of more vineyards, and nowadays, we get around 60 hectares.
Okay, and how many bottles of wine does that make?
Yeah, well, we started with really few bottles in 2006 when we started to make wines, because when we started, we just started with the vineyards.
Uh-huh.
But it's in 2006 when we built the winery and start to make our wines.
Mm-hmm.
So in that time, we made 10,000 bottles, more or less, small production.
Yeah.
Every year, produce it a little bit more, till today that we are around 200,000 bottles.
Wow.
Marta ligner på ingen måde en traditionel vinbonde, men hun er inde i sagerne, og det skyldes måske det faktum, at hun drikker vin. En masse vin.
You drink wine every day?
Well, our job need that we drink every day, but it's normal that when we are here in the winery, you split, and at home, in the dinner, a small glass of wine. It's a really important wine.
Mm-hmm.
In this case, we work with a red Carignan. Some of them are really old. Red Grenache, a little bit of Cabernet Sauvignon and Merlot. And this wine have been 7 months in oak cask.
Yeah.
But in a new oak cask that we have every year in the winery. So 7 months is enough to look for a really good balance between fruit and bourbon. So when you smell, smell a ripe fruit, a prune.
I really like you're closing your eyes when you're smelling.
Yeah, thank you.
So like
I have to concentrate. When you smell a fruit like prunes, but it's easier to find smoked, toasted flavors, ripe fruit, because this wine has been 7 months in a new oak casks.
Yeah.
And if you taste.
Skål, we say in Danish. Skål.
Skål.
Jeg bliver simpelthen så inspireret, når jeg kommer ud til de her steder, hvor unge mennesker de er entreprenører og iværksættere. Og Marta og hendes mand de er helt enestående, for det hele det startede med vin. Men så fandt de ud af, at de smed resterne fra druerne ud på marken, og der kunne gå høns. Så nu producerer de altså også æg. Og fordi alle vine er økologiske, så har de får til at gå og afgræsse markerne. Og fra fårene, der får de mælk, så nu laver de også ost. Og bag fra høns og får, det samler de så sammen og ligger ved oliventræerne. Og det, de fundet ud af, det giver nogle rigtig gode oliventræer, gunstige forhold til oliventræer. Så nu producerer de også en rigtig fin olivenolie. Nå ja, og så lige lidt honning, og selvfølgelig også lige lidt sæbe. Så en masse andre produktioner er der kommet ud af, og masse andre produkter er der kommet ud af, at de også producerer en fremragende vin. Det er virkelig godt gået.